In this video, we're going to take a look at cached domain login credentials within a Windows Server network. I'll talk about what they are, how they work, and we'll also discuss some important considerations to be aware of, both as a system admin and also supporting Windows desktops on the help desk. Now, before we get started, don't forget to give the video a like if you enjoy it, and also subscribe to the ittaster channel if you haven't already to receive alerts of new content. So with that said, let's get started. When we install the Active Directory Domain Services role in Windows Server for the first time, we're building a client-server network model. One of the important things that Active Directory gives us is a directory service, a centralized store that holds information about network objects, for example, user accounts, computers, and much, much more. Now, when users log on to a computer that belongs to a Windows Server domain with their domain login credentials, the user's domain login credentials, that is their username and password, are verified by a domain controller, a DC, and the user is either granted or denied access to the network. Now, this technology enables admins to centralize network management, and it's also massively scalable. But what happens if the only domain controller fails and goes offline? There's nowhere for the client PCs to forward login requests to in order to authenticate their users. Well, this is where cached credentials come in. Users that have previously logged on to a domain controller successfully will have their domain login account information cached locally on their computer workstations by the Windows operating system. This allows users to access their computers using those cached domain login account credentials. And this is one of the reasons for caching login credentials, but not the most important one in my view. Cache logins can certainly be useful for these kinds of situations. However, it's generally considered good practice to have more than one domain controller to provide resilience so that should a domain controller fail, another domain controller is able to service user login requests as well as provide other important network services. Now, where cached login credentials really come into their own is when we have mobile users with Windows laptops. When laptop users are working in the office, the laptop is authenticated by the domain controller and managed in the usual way. However, when a user leaves the office with their company laptop to work from home, they will need to be able to log on to the laptop in order to connect home Wi-Fi, etc. Now, because the user's domain credentials have been cached locally on the Windows laptop computer by the Windows OS, the user is able to log on using those cached credentials and access the laptop and begin work. Now, there are some important considerations that I want to make you aware of when working with cached domain login credentials. The first one is to encourage users to test that they're able to log in using their cached domain login credentials before leaving site, particularly if we're setting up a device for a new user. It's important to log the user into the domain first, check everything, log the user out, disconnect the device from the network, and then test if the user is able to log back in again whilst offline. You don't want a colleague or manager with an important meeting off-site to arrive there and find that they cannot log into their device. It's also important users don't forget their login details, particularly their passwords, when working remotely offline. Resetting the password on the DC at the office won't take effect on the remote device until the user returns to the office and connects to the Windows Server domain. Now, whilst cached domain login credentials can prove very useful in some situations, consider disabling the caching of domain login credentials for devices where they're not needed for good security. Review group policy settings to ensure they meet requirements. Here you can disable caching domain login credentials, as well as specify the number of users' cached login credentials that are stored on a device locally. It's worth noting that the default policy setting on a Windows 10 computer is to cache 10 previous users' login credentials. If caching domain login credentials is disabled, when users attempt to log in offline, they will typically see the message, "The system cannot log you on now because the domain is not available." As you've seen, cached domain login credentials can prove very useful. So it really is important to understand how they work and also how to be able to tailor them to an organization's needs and security requirements, particularly when it comes to mobile devices. So that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you found it helpful. Please remember to give the video a like if you did and subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. I'm also around on social media too, and I'll leave the links below in the description. So as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.